know that the weapons of our warfare did not come. So you know that when folk try to draw you into some foolishness, you know I'm a student of the word. Somebody said, well, I heard what you call said something about you, that what you call did, and sister said what you call the what was writing about it. When you're a student of the word, you recognize that the weapons of our warfare, they're not carnal. And so because I'm knowledgeable of the word, I refuse to get drawn into something that's going to cause me to forfeit my blessing. Do you know sometimes the devil can't stop you? But what he can do is make you forfeit. Make you forfeit your stuff. In other words, pull you into a situation to make it where you're not qualified to get what God's trying to give you. And I don't know about you, I'm tired of the devil messing with my stuff. I'm tired of the devil trapped up in my stuff. I'm tired of, come on somebody, missing out on what God has for me. I want everything that God has for me. Come on somebody, give him another stage if you will. And so this is what Paul ended up telling Timothy here. He ended up telling Timothy, he said, Timothy, this is what I want you to do. He says, Timothy, let's go to verse 3. He says, Timothy, he says, I want you to suffer some hardships. A good soldier gonna have some battle scars. Ask your neighbor, say, neighbor, do you have any battle scars? Do you have any scars to show some stuff that you went through and that God brought you out of it? See, a good, solid church, come on, that's really in the place where Paul is writing to Timothy about, is going to have some people in it that's got some battle scars. Yeah. In other words, let me put it this way where you can understand it. Look, that'd be funny. If anybody